we say these many fishermen have been killed, these many fishermen have been attacked, you say they have been attacked by none. And when you say your fishermen have been attacked, you put the blame off on our fishermen.
Definitely. You can come and see not in the north, even the northwestern province, Kalpitiya. They come to that place also.
Then why do you deny the fact that there are rooms, there are possibilities of our fishermen being attacked by your navy or your fishermen?
How can the navy was not taking enough action? That was my problem all this time. When they were coming, there were no arrests. You know, even the Indian fishermen were arrested. Indian High Commission speak to the government and the next day they have been released. That is what the procedure for the all these years. But we have never confiscated earlier any vessels. We have never arrested and imprisoned any of the Tamil Nadu fishermen, right? But now, because this is continuously going on, and the northern the fishermen, they have a long march around the Jaffna Peninsula, and they started agitation. Then our navy started arresting, and we also decided to arrest and to bring. Now we have decided to release the fishermen, but not to release the vessels.
You spoke about the confiscation of the vessels. Are you handling a new successful strategy by economically weakening the fishermen, by discouraging them from coming to waters, discouraging them from, you know, continuing their profession
We are losing 95 billion rupees worth of fish per year to Tamil Nadu fishermen. You know, Professor Susei, the professor of geography in the Jaffna University, his calculation may very much more. But we have calculated about the usual number of vessels come daily. Mean value we have taken, and we have calculated at least 95 billion rupees. That means 95,000 rupees. About 700 million US dollars we are losing per year because of the Tamil Nadu fishermen.
Moving to another important issue that has been a standoff between the both countries, Kachchatheevu. We in Tamil Nadu feel it always belonged to India and it should belong to India. We have some reasons to say that. What are yours?
Even Pakistan was belonged to India. So why don't you come to claim Pakistan?
Because
it was divided only in 1947.
Because it was by an agreement.
So this is also an agreement. Hindu-Lanka agreement signed by Mrs. Bandaranaike.
But it has not been ratified by the Indian Parliament, so that is
your procedure, whether to ratify or not.
So
that is your mistake, not the Sri Lankan government.
In Tamil Nadu, we have reasons to say this always belonged to India. Sini Kupan Padayachi had it, and it belonged to the Ramanathapuram Sethupathis. But it is always seen that India gifted Kachchatheevu to Sri Lanka, which has no historical, you know, reasons to say Kachchatheevu belonged
India,
to
India. India, right, even you say that India gifted. We also gifted certain things in the same way. We have gifted the water, the sea area to India in this thing. And even we have allowed the Indian fishermen to come to Kachchatheevu to change their gears and do everything.
But why
and,
not now?
Huh?
But why not now?
Still at the feast and everything. If anybody comes for this, they are being arrested not at the Kachchatheevu point. They are all arrested only about 4-5 kilometers away from the shore.
There are reports of Indian fishermen being arrested near Kachchatheevu.
No.
So you, do you mean?
No, our navy cannot.
Why should we arrest to
go up to Kachchatheevu when there are thousands of vessels nearby the shore? First, we have to arrest those people to go to Kachchatheevu.
By saying that, do you mean to say India has fishing rights around Kachchatheevu?
Pardon?
No
fishing rights, but to come and change the gears.
But
it's according to the agreement.
Was fishing rights not part of the 1974 agreement?
No, nothing.
So we had the rights to dry away the nets. 1974 agreement, but do we have it now?
No, it's not.
But
there.
Why did it
even there had been an agreement in 2008? There they have said that we two to discuss and sort out all the problems created by the Indian and the Sri Lankan fishermen. That's all. And the Indian center understands very well, not the Tamil Nadu. Now, how do you say that you are complaining? The same Tamil Nadu politicians, Madam Jayalalitha, Karunanidhi, they are the people espousing the cause of human rights of the northerners, northern Tamil people. The other way, they go back and they defend the rights of the violators of the human rights of the northern people. The northerners are, after 30 years war, now only they are earning some money in the sea. You know the hub of fisheries in Sri Lanka is north. North gave us 43% of the 43% of the national production before the insurrection. It dropped to 7%. Now it has increased to 18%. That the Tamil Nadu politicians and the Tamil Nadu fishermen, they only violate the fundamental rights of our northern fishermen for what they are espousing now. So much of talk. Double standards.
Supreme Court, said the Indo-Sri Lanka Accord, is not right in the way of merging the north and the east. Similarly, agree?
No.
If our Supreme Court says Kachatheev belong to India, it should have been ratified and it belongs to India. Would you agree that?
You are wrong, no? Our Indo-Lanka agreement you go through, they say by 1988, December 31st, you have to hold a referendum and to decide about the amalgamation. So the two provinces are amalgamated temporarily, and that will have to be decided by. So no referendum was held. That is why the Supreme Court said it is no more.
If such technical reasons are cited, and our Supreme Court says Kachatheev belongs to India and it does not.
No, your Supreme Court has never said.
No, if it says.
They have
asking you a question. There are courts, our Chief Minister.
Then the Supreme Court, your Supreme Court, and the your government has to decide.
No,
on
it. Could be.
I don't think the Indian Supreme Court will ever nullify an agreement by leaders of the two countries.
Let's talk about solutions. What do you think? Both the sides, both the fishermen, both the countries need peace in the waters too. How do you think this has to be solved? Should we come to the negotiating table? How should this be resolved?
We are in the negotiating table. Mm-hmm. We have done our part. 2011 December, we had the discussions here, right? So then the next round goes to India. So it should have been in 6 months' time in Delhi. That is 2012 June, but never happened. Now it is 2013.
What reason was given?
No reason. But unofficially they say, because they are at a weak wicket, that is why they don't hold the joint working group. The joint working group, because they have no answer to tell us why this amount of thousands of people coming to our territory and taking our resources and go back.